Hi viewer, welcome to LimTV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Mathematics Form 3, Lesson Number 6. The topic it is Quadratic Expression and Equation 2. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudoni. Welcome. The first thing you're going to do, you're going to look at the lesson course. Today we are going to solve the quadratic equation graphically. That is the work we are supposed to do, solving graphically. And we have the first example that we have there. We have a quadratic equation. We are given a quadratic equation. That is x squared minus 3x then plus 10 is equal to 0. And you are required to solve that equation graphically. The first step, it is what we have on the screen. Make the table where now you have the x and y. In our previous lesson, we said that we can be given equations like those and then you are told to solve. This is a quadratic equation. So you need to get the values of y. So the values of y you're supposed to solve using the calculator very first, where there is x replaced with negative 5, negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, and negative 1, 0, and 1. Those are the values that I've taken. So with that now, after replacing the value of x, the first value of x being negative 5, we get the value of y being 25. Then, replacing the value of x being negative 4, we get 18. Then, when we replace with negative 3, we get 8. And negative 2, we get 0. Then, negative 1, we get negative 6. Then, 0, we get negative 10. And 1, we get negative 12. So, with that now, that is where now you're supposed to get the coordinates, then plot, and then join the plot. This is the way you're supposed to get it. You have the equation there after plotting, the graph there after plotting. The points that you can see in bold, these are the points that we have plotted. We have plotted the point. Then from there we join using a smooth curve. Now, what is the solution to our equation? Remember, I was told that the equation is equal to 0. So I'll get where the graph cut the x-axis. So with that, I can get where the graph cut the x-axis as the point 5, 0. That means my first value of x is equal to 5. Then I also get negative 2, 0. So I can also get the next value of x is negative 2. That is how I solve the quadratic equation graphically. We get to another example. You are given the equation like that, y is equal to x squared plus 4x then plus 8. You have you need to get that table and then get the limit. Then from there you plot. You have the limits there being negative 4 and 1. From there you, remember I've said you just use the calculator, replace the values of x with those values of x that you are given, each will give you that value of y. So with that now we plot them. Plot the point. This is the kind of the graph that you are going to get. But now you are going to get the graph does not touch the x-axis. What does it mean? It means my equation doesn't have roots. Remember, we said that there are three ways that you can get the root. In case now you get b squared minus 4ac is less than 0. It means that it doesn't have roots. These are the kind of equations. The equations we solve it graphically and they never touch the graph, the x-axis. That is the reason as to why we are saying it doesn't have roots. We get the third example. We have an equation there that is y is equal to x squared plus x plus 1. So what are we required to do? Still we get that table. Remember, we cannot solve these equations graphically without the table. So we need to get the values of y. The values of y, you have said, you just get them after replacing the values of x in the equation. That is the way what we have. After getting those points, we plot the point that we join them and then join and draw the graph. You can be able to see that we have the graph after plotting that point, after joining those points, we just get the graph. What are the solutions? The solutions, you have them. It is where the graph cuts the x-axis. So you can be able to see the first value of x, it is x negative 2.3 and x 1.3. Those are the solutions to the equation. Now, solution to the equation, that is a graph that we have solved. And then the solutions, we just get them where now we have. How do we get the solutions? For example, if at all you have that graph or that kind of a graph, or you have drawn a graph and you have gotten that, where I've marked A and B, that is where we get the solutions. So you can be able to see the point which you are saying. It is the point that cut the x-axis. Let us look at the kind of equations. Remember that in our previous lesson, when we are using the quadratic formula, we said there are three solutions that we can be able to get. These are the kind of solutions. For example, we have the first one where we have only one solution. Square, perfect quadratic. You just get one solution. Example two, we have two solutions, non-perfect quadratic equations. And then example three, we have no roots, no real roots. This means that my number that is in under square root in the quadratic formula is less than zero. It means that it doesn't have real roots. That is what you can be able to see. Activity for today, you are required to draw the graph of y is equals to x squared for the values of negative 4 to 4. So the first thing, draw the table. After getting the table, fill in the values of y, of x. Then after filling in the values of y, you plot the point, then join the point. You finally get the answers. So in that, that is the activity. For more information, you can get the reference from KRB 2003, Secondary Mathematics Student Book 3, that edition. For more information, you can get us through the SMS, your SMS to the number, through the YouTube, through the Facebook, and also you can also Twitter us through that. Stay tuned to Erin TV. Thank you.